Professor Dave here. Let's learn to calculate area.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Once we know how to calculate one-dimensional lengths, like perimeters and diameters, it is time to learn how to calculate two-dimensional areas. This is the amount of surface that a figure covers. We must understand that while side lengths and perimeters can be measured in any unit of distance, like meters, area will be expressed in square units, like square meters, which are meters squared. To see why, let's look at something simple, like a square. Say this square has a side length of 5 meters. How much surface does it cover? To answer that, we can take this line segment that represents one side of the square and realize that to span the shape, we are extending this line segment across the shape. So it's a 5 meter length that is being pushed across the 5 meter length of the adjacent side. 5 meters times 5 meters gives us 25 meters squared. We must remember that units will be manipulated just like algebraic variables, so meters times meters is meters squared, just the way that x times x is x squared. So with that, we understand the formula for the area of a square. It is a side times a side, and by definition, the sides of a square are the same, so it's side squared. If we are looking at some other rectangle that is not a square, the area will be length times width, which will be different numbers. Here is a rectangle that is 4 meters by 6 meters, so the area is 24 meters squared. This approach works for any parallelogram as well, but instead of multiplying the sides, we multiply the base times the height. The height of a parallelogram is essentially its width, which we get if we draw a line between the base and the opposite side that is perpendicular to both. It becomes very clear why this works if we draw the height right here, chop off this triangular segment, and move it to the other side to make a perfect rectangle. Now we can see that base times height on the parallelogram is the same as length times width on the corresponding rectangle. Now that we are back to rectangles, let's draw the diagonal, thus splitting it into two triangles. Each triangle has half the area of the rectangle. That's how we get the area of a triangle. We multiply the base times the height, which would give us the area of the rectangle this triangle fits into, but then we cut it in half. 1/2 base times height. So this triangle, with a base of 6 meters and a height of 4 meters, will have an area of 12 square meters. This works whether the triangle is a right triangle or not. Even though it's a little harder to see how this triangle is half of this rectangle, because it splits the rectangle up into more than two pieces, we can still use 1/2 base times height. Trapezoids are a little different. For these, we do 1/2 the height times the sum of the two bases. So with bases of 6 and 10 meters and a height of 4 meters, we plug these all in to get an area of 32 square meters. Sometimes we will want to find the area of a shape that is quite irregular. To do this, we might break these figures up into simpler shapes that are more familiar. Take this shape. Given all of these side lengths, we can split this up into two rectangles. Then we just get the areas of the two rectangles and add them together. Same with this figure, which can be split up into a rectangle and a triangle. We just get all the side lengths and then plug values into their respective equations for area. With circles, things are a bit different. The area for a circle is given by pi r squared, or pi times the radius squared. So if a circle has a radius of 3 meters, the area will be 9 pi square meters. Knowing this, we can calculate the area of even more irregular figures, as there are ones that will have rectangular pieces and semicircular pieces. We can just split these up like we did before, and the rectangular part will be easy, while for the semicircle, we figure out a way to get the radius of the circle, and then we calculate pi r squared and just cut it in half, since it's half a circle. And that's really all we need to know to calculate the area of simple shapes and some irregular ones. So it's a good idea to memorize this handful of formulas for the areas of a square, rectangle, parallelogram, triangle, trapezoid, and circle. Let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.